Doctor Mavrodakis, are you ready?
Can you hear me?
Yes, doctor. Okay, I'm going to introduce you.
Thank you.
Okay. Dr. Nikolaos Mavrodakis was born in Chania, Crete, Greece in 1981. He obtained the diploma in electronic and computer engineering, the MSc degree and the PhD from the School of Electronic and Computer Engineering in Technical University of Crete, Chania, Greece, in 2006, 2010, and 2016, respectively. He has been an invited researcher with AMS Austria, 2010 to 2011, and with ADMOS Germany, in 2012. He had been a member of the AKV3 Advanced MOSFET Compact Model Development Team since 2010 to 2017, and he has the researcher in charge for complete extraction of AKV3 model at many projects with industry. He had been a research associate with the School of Electronic and Computer Engineering at Technical University of Crete in Greece from 2010 to 2017, emphasizing noise characterization and compact modeling of micro and nanoelectronic devices. Currently, he's postdoctoral research at Autonomous University of Barcelona, and he focuses his research is the compact modeling of noise in graphene and 2D material devices. He has authored or co-authored more than 20 articles in peer review, scientific journals, and conference. Well, welcome Dr. Mavrodakis from Universidad Autónoma de Barcelona. Our speaker will present the topic one under F, noise modeling in microwave graphene transistors. Doctor, you have 30 minutes for your exposition. After this, we will have a question session of 15 minutes. To the audience, please, all the questions go to the end of the exposition, and questions should be written in the chat. Dr. Mavrodakis, please start your presentation.
Good morning and good afternoon to everyone. My name is Nikolaos Mavrodakis and I'm a postdoctoral researcher at the Department of Electronic Engineering at the Autonomous University of Barcelona in the group of Professor David Jimenez. I would like to thank a lot the organizers for inviting me to give this talk. The title of this presentation is Bias-Dependent Modeling for Low-Frequency Noise Mean Value and Variance in Single-Layer Graphene FETs. So, the basic objective of our work is to investigate thoroughly the low-frequency noise in single-layer graphene FETs, to see from where it stems, and to study its mean value and statistical behavior. The final goal was to create accurate physics-based compact models that can be used in circuit simulators. But why low-frequency noise is so significant? First of all, it can be a severe barrier in circuit design, both in analog and RF applications, as it can be upconverted to phase noise in voltage control oscillators, for example. Furthermore, it can limit the sensitivity of chemical and biological sensors or even optoelectronic devices, which are some of the most significant applications of graphene. Last but not least, it can be proved a very useful tool for characterizing the reliability of the devices. In fact, the quality of graphene is closely related to the level of noise, because the trapping-detrapping process, which is one of the most important generators of low-frequency noise, can be easily activated through broken bonds in the graphene. Let's now see the general outline of this presentation. First of all, we are going to theoretically research low-frequency noise in graphene FETs. See in general, what are the noise sources in semiconductor devices, And then, more specifically, what are the contributions to low-frequency noise, especially graphene FETs? So, we have the carrier number fluctuation effect, or delta N model, which generates noise due to trapping the trapping effect in the oxide of the device. Mobility fluctuation effect, or delta M model, on the other hand, considers noise as a result of the fluctuations in bulk mobility and is usually expressed by Hood's empirical relation. Finally, contact resistance can also have a contribution to low-frequency noise, especially away from Dirac voltage. Afterwards, the low-frequency noise mean value and variance models will be derived and presented. Then, the graphene FETs under test and the measurement conditions will be shown, with two different kinds of devices used in this work: solid-state gated and liquid-gated ones. The first ones are short-channel devices provided from IEMN group from University of Lille in France and Professor Henry Happy, and are used for the extraction of the mean value low-frequency noise model. The second ones are long-channel liquid-gated devices provided from ICN2 Institute from Barcelona and Professor Jose Garrido, and are used for the extraction of the low-frequency noise variance model. Finally, we will demonstrate the validation of the models with data, both for the mean value and variance of low-frequency noise, and we will end up with some conclusions. The main noise sources in transistors are depicted in this slide. So we can see thermal noise, independent of frequency, above corner frequency FC, while below FC, low-frequency noise dominates. Low-frequency noise can either be in the form of random telegraph noise for very small devices, or in the form of flicker 1 over F noise for longer devices, which is inversely proportional to frequency, as can be seen from the plot. Let's now proceed with the modeling of low-frequency noise, and firstly with the carrier number fluctuation model. As mentioned before, carrier number fluctuation effect is created by trapping the trapping process in the oxide of the device. Each such trap can create a random telegraph signal which corresponds to a Lorentzian spectrum. In small devices where number of traps are few, random telegraph noise prevails. On the contrary, in large devices where traps are a lot, the superposition of such uniformly positioned Lorentzians can generate 1 over F noise, as can be seen from the plot. It is important to mention that in our data or in any other low-frequency noise data reported in literature, no random telegraph signal noise has been observed in graphene FETs so far. In order to implement a model for low-frequency noise, a good IV graphene FET model was needed, and such a reliable chemical potential-based model has already been developed by our group. Now, initially, we made some approximations in order to make equation simpler. So, quantum capacitance CQ was considered linear with the chemical potential VC according to this expression. Regarding noise modeling, our general methodology was based on dividing the device channel in very small slices, where each one of them is a local noise source, and all these local noise sources are considered uncorrelated. The relative current fluctuation is given by equation 1, where QGR is the graphene charge, QT is the trap charge, and with N are the densities respectively. Graphene charge is calculated as here, where R0 is the residual charge, which dominates at Dirac voltage or charge neutrality point CNP, and can be extracted accurately from IV data. By applying charge conservation law, we can take equation 2, where Q top back and C top back are the top back oxide charge and capacitance respectively, while with C is the sum of the top and back oxide capacitances. Equation 1, because of equation 2, is transformed as here. And then from here, we can calculate the power spectral density, or PSD, of the local noise source, which, as you can see, it has a bias-dependent term, while S delta and T square is a constant term called trap charge density fluctuation. Here, NT small is the trap charge density, NT capital is the oxide volumetric trap density per unit energy, which is also used as a low-frequency noise mean value model parameter, and lambda is the tunneling attenuation distance. This proposed methodology was first published in Nanoscale Journal 2 years ago. Since the devices under test are short-channel devices, short-channel effects like velocity saturation, and how they contribute to low-frequency noise shall be considered. In this work, we use a two-branch velocity saturation model, where, as you can see from this relation, USAT is constant near CNP and inversely proportional to chemical potential away from CNP. Drain current can then be calculated as here, where the denominator of drain current is called L effective and shows the contribution of velocity saturation to drain current. Then from here, the relation that gives the integral variable change from X to VC, which is essential for the extraction of low frequency noise models, is derived. The effect of velocity saturation on low frequency noise comes from the second term of this equation, as well as from L effective, as we are going to see. In order to calculate the total drain current noise, we must integrate all local noise sources from source to drain. By changing integration variables from length to chemical potential VC, according to the equation we saw just before, we end up to this integral for a delta N model with GVC, a normalized drain current term. This integral can be solved analytically and provide us a compact solution. Let's proceed now to the delta M and delta R mean value models implementation. Regarding Hood's model, the same procedure as before is followed. So the power spectral density is calculated locally in the channel by using the empirical Hood's formula, which shows an inversely proportional to graphene charge behavior, as you can see in this expression. Alpha H is the Hood's parameter, also used as a low frequency noise mean value model parameter. Again, by integrating along the channel, an analytical solution can be obtained. Now, a simple series resistant low frequency noise model is used for contact resistant contribution taken from models for CMOS devices, where SDR square is also used as a model parameter. To calculate the total low frequency noise model, we just need to add the three mechanisms that were analyzed before: the carrier number fluctuation effect, the mobility fluctuation effect, as well as the series resistance contribution. The analytical low frequency noise mean value model presented here is published in ACS Applied Electronic Materials Journal. So after finishing with the demonstration of the mean value model, we shall proceed to the variance model. While there is a significant number of works regarding low-frequency noise mean-value modeling in graph infets, no studies are available that deal with the low-frequency noise variability in these devices, even though this variability is equally significant to its mean value. The large deviations of low-frequency noise observed in graph infets makes it important and urgent to develop statistical low-frequency noise models to investigate the physics behind this variability. In the present work, such a new physics-based statistical compact model is proposed for the first time for the variance of normalized with area and divided by squared drain current output noise. This quantity is often used in similar works in CMOS technologies, since it follows an 1 over area scaling, and that is the reason why we also use it in this work for graph infets. Low-frequency noise deviations in graph infets stem from the variations of the parameters of the physical mechanism that generate low-frequency noise and not from IV quantities. These parameters are the number of traps, NTR, for the carrier number fluctuation effect, and the Hood's parameter, alpha H, for the mobility fluctuation effect. The process for the derivation of the variance model is similar to the mean value model. Thus, the variance is calculated locally in the channel for each low frequency noise mechanism in order to ensure that each drain current deviation delta ID caused by a fluctuation such as a specific trap at any tiny area of the channel will contribute independently. Then the integration along the channel leads to an analytical compact solution with the help of the chemical potential based model that we have already mentioned. It is important to say that applying fundamental laws of statistics, as here, will be proved very useful for the extraction of the variance model. Here, Y might be number of traps NTR or Hood's parameter alpha H, where number of traps equals to the area times the trap charge density. The normalized low frequency noise local in the device channel for a slice delta x for delta n effect is given by this expression, while the total low frequency noise is calculated by integration of the local noise along the channel as here. Then, by taking the variance of this equation, we have the basic expression to start the extraction for variance model. Since local noise sources are considered uncorrelated, and since integral is in fact a sum, variance can get into the integral as here. In solid-state oxide FETs, a number of traps is known to follow Poisson distribution, which means that its variance equals to its mean value. Then, if the equation of the integral variable change that we saw before is also applied, we can take this integral for delta n variance model, which can be solved analytically and give us a compact solution. Regarding the delta m low frequency noise variance model, a similar procedure as in delta n case is followed, which ends up in this integral, which can be also solved analytically. Since there are no information for the value of variance of Hood's parameter in literature, we can assume that it equals with this expression in order to ensure that we have the same 1 over area scaling as we did with delta n variance model. N alpha h here is a specific density used as a low frequency noise variance model parameter. Now, in order to calculate the total variance, the delta n and delta m variances must be added under the assumption that they are uncorrelated. This assumption does not error a lot since delta n and delta m are dominant at different operating conditions. This analysis here has been published in Nanoscale Advances Journal. While number of traps follow a Poisson distribution in silicon oxide devices, as we said before, it is experimentally shown in this work that this is not valid for the liquid gated devices under test. This might be caused both by the electrolyte graphene interface in graphene FETs under study, and in general by the premature state of the graphene FET technology development, which could permit external factors to influence the performance of the devices. Thus, NTCOF is defined as a new low frequency noise variance model parameter. In general, variance model parameters NTCOF and N alpha H are extracted from low frequency noise variance data, but their value can also be confirmed by extracting the low frequency noise models for every measured sample and then calculate the variance and mean value of NTR and alpha H, as it will be shown later. Finally, low frequency noise data has been shown to follow log normal distribution many times in CMOS devices according to this expression, and here it is shown for the first time in graphene FETs. After finishing with the presentation of the models, we can now proceed to the description of the device under test and the measurement setups. As we mentioned before, two different kinds of devices and measurement setups are used in this work. The first one is provided by IEMN Group and is used for the low frequency noise mean value model validation. In more detail, IV and low frequency noise data were measured for 6 different solid gated graphene FETs with a width of 12 micrometers and for 3 available channel lengths, a length of 300 nanometer for A300 and B300 devices, a length of 200 nanometer for A200 and B200 devices, and a length of 100 nanometer for A100 and B100 devices. The gate voltage was swept from 0 to 1.4 volts, covering regions both away and near CNP. Moreover, 5 different drain voltage values were recorded, a VDS of 30 millivolts, 60 millivolts, 0.1, 0.2, and 0.3 volts, in order to cover the low and high electric field region, which is crucial for studying velocity saturation effect on low frequency noise. The second set of graphene FETs and measurements was provided by ICN2 Institute and is used for the validation of low frequency noise variance model. In more detail, on wafer low frequency noise and IV measurements were conducted at top solution gated single layer graphene FETs at 3 different device geometries. A geometry of 20 over 20 micrometers, a geometry of 50 over 50 micrometers, and finally a geometry of 100 over 100 micrometers. Gate voltage was shaped from strong P-type to strong N-type region, including the CNP, with a step of 5 millivolts, while drain voltage was kept low and constant at 50 millivolts. A significant number of samples were measured for each available geometry in order to ensure that we have adequate data to characterize low-frequency noise statistics. In more detail, the analysis took place at around 20 to 25 samples from geometry 20 over 20, 25 to 28 samples from geometry 50 over 50, and 45 to 53 samples from geometry 100 over 100 after the exclusion of any outlier. The reason why the number of samples is not constant for each geometry is that some measurements might behave as outliers in some specific bias conditions, but not in the whole gate voltage range. Now, low frequency noise was measured for frequencies from 1.5 Hz to 2.5 kHz in all cases. While in order to study the bias dependence of low frequency noise, we had to calculate it at 1 Hz, and this was done by an averaging from 10 to 40 Hz. Let's proceed to the results now. And firstly, regarding the low frequency noise mean value model and the first set of devices and measurements. The IV model is presented in this slide since low frequency noise expresses the fluctuation of current, thus the absolute ID has to be well described. Drain current is shown in these plots for all available devices versus effective gate voltage. And at every plot, all the available drain voltages are shown. The fitting of the model, shown with solid lines, with experimental data, shown with markers, is of high quality, both near and away CNP, at P-type region. As you can observe, there is an asymmetry in drain current data at high gate voltages, since they are lower in N-type than P-type region. And this can be explained either by a different mobility at the two operating regimes, or by a parasitic PN or NN diode, which is formed between the channel and the contact when the device is biased in the P or N region respectively. And this can give rise to different contact resistances. The model, on the other hand, is symmetric, as you can observe, so it can provide identical behavior at P and N type regimes away from CNP. The best fit was achieved at the whole P-type region near CNP and up to a value of effective gate voltage equal to 0.1 volt in N-type regime. We focused our attention on this region because it presents the highest transconductance, which, as we know, is a crucial figure of merit for RF applications. Regarding the low-frequency noise model validation, normalized drain current noise divided by squared drain current at 1 Hz is shown in these plots versus effective gate voltage for all the graphene FETs under test. In the left subplot of each plot, lowest and highest drain voltages are shown, while in the right subplot, the rest of them. Markers again represent the data and solid line the model, while with dashed line, the model without the effect of a low saturation is presented, which is also called a long channel model. As you can see, in all cases, data follow the well-known M-shape with a minimum at CNP, and the model also follows this trend. It has been shown in our published work that delta M is significant near CNP, following a lambda shape, while delta N is responsible for the M-shape. Also, contact resistance RC increases low-frequency noise at higher P and N-type regions. What is also of utmost importance is that the low frequency noise data at higher electric fields are importantly reduced due to the velocity saturation effect, and the total model captures this reduction without the need of any fitting parameter. In more detail, as you can observe from the highest VDS case in left subplot of each plot, solid lines, which are the total model, fits the data, while long channel model with dashed lines overestimate low frequency noise data. Here in this table, the extracted IV and low frequency noise parameters are presented for every device under test. The first four parameters, mobility, effective gate voltage, residual charge, and contact resistance, are extracted from low drain voltage IV data, While at high drain voltage IV data, the phonon energy H omega parameter, which is related to the velocity saturation effect, is derived. Regarding low frequency noise, Hood's parameter is extracted from CNP, and then NT is also derived from the peaks of the M shape. Finally, SDR square is extracted away from CNP. The above three low frequency noise parameters are derived at low drain voltage regime, and the good fitting at higher drain voltage is achieved with the value of H omega extracted from IV data. In general, the proposed low frequency noise mean value model is proved to be very consistent. Both delta N and delta M mechanisms contribute at different operating conditions, and this is covered by the model. Finally, velocity saturation effect results in the significant reduction of low frequency noise at high electric field regime, and the model precisely fits this behavior. Let's proceed now to the results regarding the low frequency noise variance model and the second set of devices and measurements. The IV model is presented in this slide, where in the upper plots for all the three devices under test. Again, the markers represent the mean drain current data from all the samples, while the lines represent the model, which is extracted accurately in all regions of operation. Bottom left plot shows cumulative distribution function, CDF, of the natural logarithm of normalized with area and divided by square drain current output noise for the 100 over 100 micrometer graph infet at three different gate voltage values. Markers present the extracted CDF of the random variable X equals to the natural logarithm of normalized noise, while the solid lines the theoretical CDF under the consideration that X is normally distributed. The precise fitting among markers and lines confirms that low frequency noise data follow a log normal distribution, something that is shown for the first time in graph infets. The next two plots show the correlation of IV quantities such as effective gate voltage and drain current with low frequency noise data for the same 100 over 100 device for two different gate voltage values. This correlation is insignificant, as you can see, and as we have mentioned previously, which is indicative of the fact that low frequency noise data variations are caused from the fluctuations of number of traps NTR and Hood's alpha H parameters. Upper plots of this slide depict normalized low frequency noise versus effective gate voltage for all the three devices under test. At each plot, black markers show the mean value low frequency noise data, while purple and green markers the plus minus two sigma data values respectively. Smaller red markers show the data for all the measured samples. Solid lines represent the models, where black lines are the mean value model, while purple and green lines the plus minus two sigma models respectively. The behavior of the models is very accurate for both mean values and statistical plus minus two sigma cases, as you can see. Now, bottom plots depict variance of normalized low frequency noise versus effective gate voltage, again for all three devices under test. Markers represent the data, solid lines the total variance model, while dashed and dotted lines stand for delta N and delta M variance contributions respectively. The fitting is very consistent, while the shape of delta N and delta M models prove that these effects act similarly as in the low frequency noise mean value model. That said, delta N effect is responsible for the M shape of low frequency noise variance, as it was for the M shape of the mean low frequency noise, while delta M contributes near the CNP as it did for the mean low frequency noise, while it retains its lambda shape trend. Low frequency noise variance model parameters can be extracted from this plot. Thus, N alpha H can be extracted from CNP, while NTQF from the peaks of the M shape. Additionally, the new low frequency noise variance model shows a deviation from the experimental data at high N-type conduction regime, probably due to delta R contribution to variance, which is not included in this study so far. In the left plot of this slide, the standard deviation of the natural logarithm of normalized output noise is shown versus effective gate voltage for all the three devices under test. Again, lines are the model while markers are the data. Apart from the good fitting, it is worthwhile mentioning that the values of sigma from 0.1 to 1, as you can see, are quite close to CMOS devices of same dimensions, something that indicates an acceptable performance of the specific graphene FETs under test. Moreover, another crucial observation is the weak bias dependence of standard deviation data, with a rather smooth fluctuation near the CNP and a slight decrease away from the CNP, which is remarkably captured by the proposed model.
Excuse me, Dr. Mavredakis, you have five minutes more, please.
Are extracted from low frequency noise variance data, as shown in previous slide. Regarding NTCOF, it was extracted much greater than unity for all graphene FETs, which means the Poisson distribution, that is the case for trap statistics in silicon oxide transistors, as we mentioned before, is not valid in this study. This can be either because of the electrolyte graphene interface or the premature stage of graphene FET technologies in general, as we have already mentioned. To investigate deeper the latter, low frequency noise mean value model parameters, NTR and alpha H, are extracted for every available measured sample as it is shown in the right plot. Then the variance and the LN mean value of the extracted NTR and alpha H parameters can be calculated. And thus, the low frequency noise variance model parameters can be estimated by these equations. Astonishingly, these calculated parameters are exact the same with the values extracted from low frequency noise variance data, as we saw before, confirming the accuracy of extracting these parameters from variance data, and in general, confirming the validity of the model. The table here shows all the extracted parameters for IV, low frequency noise, and low frequency noise variance model for all the devices under test. It was shown in this analysis that low frequency noise deviations are not related with IV quantities, but strongly depend on fluctuations of parameters of the main mechanisms that generate low frequency noise, which are number of traps NTR for delta N and Hooch parameter alpha H for delta M effect. A physics-based low frequency noise variance model is for the first time proposed with exceptional performance, where delta N and delta M contributors behave similarly as they did for mean value case. Finally, number of traps are shown not to follow Poisson distribution for the liquid gated graphene FETs under test. I would like to thank you all for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Mavredakis. It was a very interesting presentation. And are there any questions from the audience? Yes, we have some questions from Aníbal. The first question is, what is the impact of noise gate resistance on low frequency noise in graphene FETs?
Excuse me, you said the noise gate resistance?
Yes.
Okay, we haven't studied this in graphene FETs yet, but we know that gate resistance can also have a contribution to low frequency noise, but usually it's not very significant. But yet we haven't incorporated this part of the model in this work yet, so it's like a future work to study this effect.
Okay, thank you. There is another question. Can you please mention what you have studied low frequency noise in liquid gated devices? For which application this device has been used?
Well, we studied these devices because we had them available in with some cooperations with the ICN2 Institute in Barcelona. So these devices are usually used in neural sensors in a human brain, but I'm not really expert on applications. So we just had the available data from these devices. We had some projects, so we investigated these devices for this reason.
Okay, for which applications these devices have been used?
Yeah, to my knowledge, they use them to some neural sensors, brain sensors and things like this to sense neural signals.
Okay, thank you, doctor. Dr. Eloy, do you have any question?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Dr. Mavridakis, your presentation was pretty good. And I have just a question. Which are the figures of merit at high frequencies of the GFETs which are affected by low frequency noise?
Well, to my knowledge, low frequency noise can affect high frequency by upconversion to phase noise in such applications.
Okay. Continue, please.
No, please.
Yes. Thank you. Which are the strategies to diminish low frequency noise in GFETs? The main strategies.
Okay. So one way is to use, for example, specific substrates. So it is shown that boron nitride substrates have a very good effect, and they can eliminate low frequency noise. More or less, this is what I know, especially for graphene FETs. And then what you can do is to choose some specific bias conditions where noise is not very high. So that is why we also study low frequency noise versus bias to see where it's maximized and to see where it's less.
Okay.
So yeah, more or less.
Okay, excellent. And just a last question. Which is the physical origin of low frequency noise in GFETs?
Wait a minute. So yeah, mostly in this work, we saw that low frequency noise comes from two main physical mechanisms. The one is the trapping in the oxide that I presented in the first slides, where a trap can be captured and then released. And this can cause a fluctuation in drain current, for example. And this fluctuation can also cause noise because current is fluctuated. Also, we said about the mobility fluctuation effect, which has to do with fluctuations of the mobility. And this is described by the empirical Hood's formula. So yeah, more or less, these are the two main effects that are the physical mechanism of low frequency noise.
Yes, of course. The latter mechanism is pretty interesting because it is claimed that in graphene, the transport is almost ballistic. Which are the origins of the mobility variations in graphene? That's a question.
To be honest, this kind of devices that we have studied, the channel length is not so small in order to speak about ballistic transport.
Okay.
But 1 minute. Yeah. So 1 minute. Let's see. Yeah, more or less. One other thing that we know is that in graphene FETs, especially, the mobility fluctuation has to do with the number of layers. So the higher the number of layers, we have more intense mobility fluctuation. But in single layer devices that we study, it's not so intense, but still it can have a small contribution, especially near the Dirac voltage.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. These are all my questions.
Thank you. Thank you, Doctora Maria Elena.
Thank you, Dr. Eloy. There is no more questions. The last, Dr. Ivan Puchades asks, could you briefly show again how the mobility was extracted?
For which of the two kind of devices? Let me go. Maybe I can. So yeah, for the extraction of the mobility, more or less, we are using a simple linear method for the linear region. where the mobility is extracted in the area away from the CNP. I don't know if this answers the question or not.
Dr. Puchades.
Yes, thank you. Yes, thank you. That's all I wanted to see where that was extracted.
More or less. For example, here it's around this area from the linear region. Yeah,
you're showing some nice numbers up to 7,000 centimeters squared per volt second. So that's very good results.
Okay,
there is no more questions. Dr. Mavredakis, we're awarding you this diploma. I'm going to share it.
Should I stop saying me? Yeah, okay.
Okay. El Instituto Politécnico Nacional, Cátedra Eugenio Méndez de Ocurro, otorga el presente reconocimiento al doctor Nicolaos Mavredakis por su participación en el seminario en línea High Frequency and Terahertz Devices and Circuits Perspectives on Emerging and Advanced Technologies, Part 1, con la conferencia 1 over F Noise Modeling in Microwave Graphene Transistors, llevada a cabo los días 26 y 27 de noviembre de 2020, la técnica al servicio de la patria. Thank you very much, Dr. Mavredakis.
Thank you very much.
Thanks to the audience for your attention.